गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन. आई एम गौरव गुप्ता एज मैथमेटिक्स टीचर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व एक्सरसाइज 2.3. हाँ, इट्स वेरी इजी. यू हैव टू लर्न सम कॉन्सेप्ट हाउ वी गेट सॉल्व द इक्वेशन इन विच वी गेट वेरिएबल्स ऑन द बोथ द साइड्स. हाउ वी गेट द सॉल्यूशन और हाउ वी गेट द वैल्यूज ऑफ एक्स व्हेन एवर एक्स इज ऑन बोथ द साइड ऑफ द इक्वेशंस. It's very easy to solve. Before to start the video, I request everyone, please don't forget to subscribe my channel Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. If you really like my video, so please to press the button of bell so you can get automatic notification whenever I upload a new video. So don't worry, obviously we will solve each and every question. So please make a look first. Solving equation having variable on both sides. It means we have to solve the equation having variable. You know what's the variable? X, Y, Z, these are the variables. But in such type of question, you get only one type of variable, either X, Y or Z. Maybe any one, but the variable is only one. And you get the variable on both the sides. It means you get the variables on the left hand side as well as the right hand side, and you have to solve it and get the values of the variable. That is the whole process of this question. How we do and what we have to do in simplest way to solve this question, try to do our before to start the exercise. I am going to take its examples, because examples are the basics, or you can say that bits of the building. So if you can't read the statement as well as do not do your examples, so it's very typical to understand the exercise and you are not able to do the exercise. That's why I'm always taking an example, then I will come on the exercise. So this is your first example. Your first example is solve 2x minus 3 is equal to x plus 2. First approach that you have to follow. What's the approach? What you have to do? You have to do separate the variable terms as on one side and the remaining terms, numbers terms on the one side. Either you can use either left hand side or right hand side, whatever you will choose. But keep in mind, you have to separate the variable terms on one side and the remaining terms on the right hand side. We are doing same thing here. Here, because we are getting the variable terms is here 2x. And x is also variable, because 2x and x both are the variables and they are on the opposite sides. So we have to combine it. So we have to take one variable on the other sides. Either you can choose this variable to take it on the left hand side, or you can choose this variable and take it on the right hand side. It's your choice. The question and the answer will be remain same. Whatever you do, the answer will be same. So I'm finding the values of x. Then what I do? Suppose this is your variable 2x. So I'm going to take x on the left hand side. And keep in mind, if you take any terms from one side to another side, then the sign of that term will be changed. For example, here the sign of x is positive. If I will take it on the left hand side, then naturally its sign becomes changed. Here the sign is not mentioned. If the sign is not mentioned, the sign is we have to consider is positive. It means this term is positive x. If we take it on the left hand side, then sign of the x becomes negative. So it becomes negative. This one is equal to plus 2. Now this is the number, so we have to separate the variables and the number on the other sides. So we get the variables on one side. So in this case we have to take minus 3 on the right hand side. Again, the sign of 3 is negative. If we take it on the right hand side, the sign of minus 3 becomes positive. So we get positive 3. Now clear in mind, this is 2x and this is x. X means if the now number is associated with x. Suppose I am talking about x. there is one number always associated with the x which is called 1. So you can write as 1 multiplied by x. It means whenever we have x, x means we have 1x. So it means this indicate here we have 1x. So 2, if we subtract 2x minus 1x, what we will get? We get only 1x, because variable is not subtract, the only the number will be subtract. So here the number is 2 and here the number is 1. So if we subtract 2 minus 1, we get 1. Again I repeat the concept, whenever you subtract and add the variable terms, in that case only numbers are added subtracted, not the variables. Variables remain the same. So these points must be keeping points. So in this we have not take the x, we have to take the terms, which is 2 and here it is 1. So 2 minus 1 which is equal to 1. So we get 1 x, 1 into x, or you can say that 1 multiplied by x. Here we get 2 plus 3 which is equal to 5. So your answer is x is equal to 5. This one is your final answer. Now some students have a question, sir, this question is correct or incorrect, how we can find out? You can verify your result, either you did good, correct or wrong, you can check. That is the verification step. So now we have to do its verification also. Now we are doing verifications. Verifications of our result. How we do? We have to take left hand side and we have to solve this. Then we have to take right hand side and solve it. If the left hand side becomes equal to right hand side, the answer is correct. Otherwise, we did wrong. So please make our left hand side. This term is your, this is your left hand side. And this one term is your right hand side. So now we have to take first our left hand side. I am taking left hand side. What is left hand side is 2x minus 3. 2x minus 3. Put its value. Now this is 2. 2 multiply x and we got the values of x is 5. It means this is indicated. 2 multiply x and the values of x is 5. So it means we have to multiply 2 multiply by 5. This sign negative as it is and 3 as it is. So what will we get? 2 multiply 10 which is equal to 10 minus 3, and 10 minus 3 is equal to 7. It means we get left hand side as a 7. Now we have to solve right hand side. Now I am going to solve our right hand side. What you have to do? I have to take the right hand side. Right hand side is here x plus 2. Now we have to put the values of x. What's the values of x is 5. Now put this value is here 5 plus 2 which is equal to 7. It means left hand side is also 7, right hand side is also 7. It means left hand side is equal to right hand sides. So result is verified. It means your answer is correct. So we are going to take each question and you have to do verifications of each question also. Keep in mind this. Not you have to do only find out the answer, but you have to keep in mind you have to do verification of each question also. So please make a note first, then I will going to take its next example. Please make a note first. So this one is your next example. The procedure is same. Firstly you have to separate the your variable terms on the left hand side and the remaining terms on the right hand side. Please make a look here. Here variable term is 5x and here variable terms is 3 by 2x. So we have to separate. So I am writing here 5x. I have to take 3 by 2x on the left hand side and its sign is here positive. Then whenever I take it on left hand side, the sign becomes negative. So what will I get? We get minus 3 by 2x. Now this one is equal to here minus 14. Now this term, which is a number, and we have to take it on the right hand side, and the sign of 7 by 2 is positive. It means whenever I will take it on right hand side, the sign it becomes negative 7 by 2. Now you have to take some assume. What's you have to assume? Whenever you find the terms in rational form, rational forms means upper terms and denominator terms, means numerator and denominator terms, then try to change all terms in numerator and denominator, because doing this we can calculate, or our calculation becomes very easy. So in this, these numbers are in rational form, numerator form and denominator form. To change all the other number also, so we can change by dividing by 1, because if any number divided by 1, we get the same number. So you can write divide by 1 to any number, whatever the number, you can write divide by 1. So I'm also here taking divide by 1. Then you know this terms is just like your LCM. Here is also same like a LCM, and you know what's the LCM. If I take LCM of 1 and 2, LCM of 1 and 2, what's the LCM of 1 and 2 is 2. So now solve this. If I take the LCM of 2, then we have to multiply it by 2, 2 into 5, which is equal to 10x. Now multiply 1 into 3, minus 3x. We have to do same thing here. What's the LCM of 1 and 2 is 2. Now multiply 2. 2 into minus 14, minus 28. 1 into minus 7, minus 7. Now solve this. 10x minus 3x, and we know variable we have to not see, we have to get only the number. Here is the positive 10, here is negative 10. 10 minus 3, which is equal to 7. So we get 7x divided by 2. Same here, minus 28 and minus 7, which is equal to minus 35. We get minus 35 divided by 2. Again, keep in mind, if you get the same number in the denominator, then you can cancel out on the both side. Again, I repeat, if you find the same number on the denominator, in this denominator, so you can cancel out each other. So in this we can cancel out, 2 will cancel out with 2. What we will got? We got here 7x, here minus 35. And we know how we calculate the values of x, because in this 7 is multiplied with x, and we have to calculate the values of x. So that's why we have to take 7 on the right hand side, and then 7 into x, it means 7 is in here multiplication form, then it goes to the denominator. So what's the values of x is minus 35 divided by 7. And if we know the tables, if we cut 7 ones are 7, 7 5s are 35. It means we get a negative sign as it is, 5 divided by 1, and divide by 1, which is equal to minus 5. It means we get the answer x is equal to minus 5. This is your answer. Now you have to take verifications. Now we have to do verifications. Our left hand side is what? Left hand side is this 5x plus means 7 divided by 2, and we know the values of x. What's the values of x is? Minus 5. So we have to replace x by minus 5. So 5, what's the values of x is? Minus 5, I am writing here, plus 7 by 2. 5 minus 5, which is minus 25, plus 7 by 2. Again, this is in forms of rational, so make it also irrational. What's the LCM of 1 and 2 is 2. Now multiply this, 2 into 25, minus 50, प्लस 1 × 7 7. इफ वी सब्ट्रैक्ट माइनस 50 प्लस 7 विच इज इक्वल टू माइनस 43 डिवाइड बाई 2. नाउ सॉल्व द राइट हैंड साइड. What's the right hand side? 3/2x minus 14. 3/2x minus 14. Now substitute 3/2. Which one is the values of x? Is minus 5. Now put it here. Minus 5 minus 14. Now multiply 3 × −5, which is equal to minus 15 divided by 2 minus 14. It is in form of rational form p by q, so make it is also in rational form by divided by 1. What's the LCM of 2 and 1 is 2. Now multiply 1 × 15 minus 15 minus 2 × 14 28 and minus 15 and minus 28 which is equal to minus 43 divided by 2. It means left hand side and right hand side becomes equal. So left hand side is equal to right hand side. Answer is verified. So these questions are very simple. You have to learn some concept and take a procedure to solve such type of questions. So please make a note first, then I will solve our next question. Now I am going to take to solve our exercise. Exercise 2.3, question number 1. We have to solve and to verify of each question. Our first question is 3x is equal to 2x plus 18. Our first step is to separate the variable. So apply this. 3x, here the sign of 2x is positive. If we take it on the left hand side, that sign becomes negative. It means it becomes negative 2x. So we get equal to only 18. Because there is no terms that we have to take it on right hand side. Again 3x minus 2x which is equal to 1x which is equal to 18. It means we get the values of x is 18. Now we have to do verifications. So our steps is verifications. We have to take our left hand side. What is left hand side? 3x. And we know the values of x is 18. It means this indicate 3 multiply x. It means we have to multiply 3 multiply 18. We get 54. Now we have to solve the right hand side. What's the right hand side? 2x plus 18. 2x plus 18. Now put the same. The values of x is 18. 2 × 18 + 18. 2 × 18 which is equal to 36 plus 18. 36 plus 18 which is equal to 54. So 54, it means left hand side is equal to right hand side. Left hand side is equal to right hand side. Our question is solved. Result is verified. Now you have to do our next question. Question number 2 is, in this the question is in terms of variable is t. In this question the variable is x, but in this question the variable is t. So we have to do the same process. Firstly we have to separate the variable on the left hand side. Then what the variable here 5t and the variable terms is here 3t. We have to take it on left hand side. The sign of 3t is positive, then it becomes negative. Now here right hand side we get only minus 5 and we have to take this minus 3 on the right hand side, and if we take minus 3 on the right hand side it becomes positive, so it becomes positive 3. If we subtract 5t minus 3t we get 2t. Again I repeat, 5 minus 3 you get 2 and the variable remains same. You not write is equal to 2, that the question will be wrong, because variable always comes with your answer and the numbers are added or subtract. So 5 minus 3 is your number, 5 minus 3 is equal to 2, and variable is always comes with the number. That's why I am write 2 into t, which is equal to, this one is minus 5 plus 3 is equal to minus 2, and we have to calculate the values of t. So we have to take 2 on the right hand side, and it is goes to the denominator, because the terms which is in numerator, and if we take it on the right hand side, it becomes in denominator terms. So what's the value of t? Minus 2 divided by 2. 2 cancel out with 2. 2 ones are 2. So we get that values of t is minus 1. Someone, students do mistake here. Cancel out 2 by 2 ones are 2. But not write the answer. Write the answer is 0. That you are wrong. Because it goes 2 ones are 2. It means it goes to 1. So your answer is 1. And the sign of negative is same. So we get answer of t is equal to minus 1. Now we have to do verifications. Our left hand side is what? 5t minus 3. Now substitute 5 multiply t, and the values of t is minus 1. This minus 3. 5 into minus 1, minus 5. Minus 3, which is equal to minus 8. Now you have to verify right hand side. What's the right hand side? Right hand side is 3t minus 5. Now we have to put the values of t. The values of t is minus 1, minus 5. 3 into minus 1, minus 3. This one is minus 5. Minus 3 and minus 5, which is equal to minus 8. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. So result is verified. So these questions are very very simple. Please make a note and take a screenshot. So our next question number is 3. 5x plus 9, which is equal to 5 plus 3x. The step is same. Firstly we have to take separation. We have to take 3x on the left hand side. The sign of the 3x becomes negative, because here it is positive. Now here is 5 positive. If we take 9 on the right hand side, then sign of the 9 becomes negative. So it becomes negative because here 9 is positive. 5 minus 3x, which is equal to 2x. And if we subtract 5 minus 9, 9 is greater number, we get the number negative. We have to calculate the values of x. So we have to take 2 on the denominator. So minus 4 divided by 2. 2 ones are 2, 2 twos are 4. It means we get minus 2 divided by 1. And we can remove 1, because if any number divided by 1, we get the same number. So we get only minus 2. So the values of x is minus 2. Now do verifications. What is our left hand side? 5x plus 9. Now put the values of x. X values is minus 2 plus 9. 5 into minus 2, minus 10 plus 9, which is equal to minus 1. Now solve right hand side. 5 plus 3x. 5 plus 3x. Now substitute the values. The values of x is minus 2. 5, 3 multiplied minus 2, which is equal to minus 6. So here I am writing minus 6. 5 minus 6, which is 1, but the number greater sign is 6. So we get negative sign. So this is left hand side is equal to right hand side. Result is verified. Now we have to take our next question. Same process. Here the variable is z. So we have to take this 2z on the left hand side, and the sign of 2z becomes negative here. 4z minus 2z, and we have to take 3, positive 3 on the right hand side, it becomes negative 3. 4z minus 2z, which is equal to 2z. 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Now we have to take it 2 on the right hand side. What we will got? Z is equal to 3 divided by 2. This one is your answer. Now you have to verify it. left hand side. What's the left hand side is 4z plus 3. Now put the values of z. What's the value of z is 3 multiply 2 plus 3. So first we multiply 4 into 3, 12 by 2 plus 3. 2 1s are 2, 2 6 are 12. It means we get 6 by 1 plus 3, and 6 by 1 is 6. So 6 plus 3 we get 9. Now solve right hand side. 6 plus 2 into z. 6 plus 2 into z. What's the value of z is 3 by 2. Please keep in mind, I do first to multiply and then we have to solve. This becomes lengthy. You can take a shortcut. What's the shortcut? You can cancel out these stuff, because if the terms are multiplied, and so you can cancel out numerator and denominator if the terms will be cancelled. Again I repeat, if the terms are multiplied, then you can cancel out numerator and denominator by any table. So we can directly cut. 2 1s are 2. So the result is 6 plus 1 multiplied 3. We get 3. 6 plus 3 is equal to 9. So our left hand side becomes right hand side. Make a note first. Now I am going to take question number 5th. Do same step. Here the variable in terms of x. So we have to separate the variable of x. Here 2x. If I take x from the left hand side, its sign is negative. Then it, whenever we take it on the right hand side, the sign becomes positive. It means we get positive x. Now 14 as it is, now we have to take minus 1 on the right hand side. It becomes positive 1. 2x plus x, which is equal to 3x. 14 plus 1, which is equal to 15. Now we have to calculate the values. Now 3 will go to the denominator part. 15 divided by 3, and 3 will be cancelled out with 5. So we get the values of x is 5. Now do verifications. Left hand side is what? 2x minus 1. 2x minus 1. Now put the values. Into x. What's the value of x is 5 minus 1. 2 into 5, 10. 10 minus 1, which is equal to 9. Now solve the right hand side. 14 minus x. 14 minus x. X the value is 5. 14 minus x, 5 is 9. Means left hand side is equal to right hand side. Now solve our question number 6. Please make a note. Before here the variable is not associated directly with number, because the number is here subtract by 1. So firstly you have to solve the bracket. If you found the term in brackets, so you have to solve this. Bracket means you have to multiply this. So solve before it. 8x plus 4, which is equal to, bracket means multiplication. 3 multiplied with x, we get 3x. 3 multiplied with minus 1, we get minus 3. This plus 7 is as it is. Now we solve the bracket. Now steps are same. We have to separate the variable. Variable is in terms of x. 8x, if we take 3x on the left hand side, then the sign becomes negative 3x. Now solve this. Here we get minus 3 plus 7. And if we take 4 on the right hand side, it becomes negative 4. 8x minus 3x, which is equal to 5x. Minus 3 minus 4, which is equal to minus 7. And this one is plus 7. 5x minus 7 plus 7, they are cancelled out. It means we get 0. Now we have to calculate the values of x. What's the values? We have to take 0 divided by 5. Please make a note. Any number, if we divide 0 by any number, we get the 0. Please make a note here. Any number divide by, sorry, 0 divide by any number is equal to 0. Please make a note here. So we get the value of x is 0. Now we have to verify the result. Left hand side is 8 into x plus 4. Put the values of x is 0 plus 4. 8 into 0, if we multiply any number with 0, we get the result 0. Again, note here, 0 multiply any number gives result 0. So 0 plus 4, which is equal to 4. This is our left hand side. Now we have to verify the right hand side. What's the right hand side is 3 into x minus 1 plus 7. Now put the values of x. 3, 0 minus 1 plus 7. 0 minus 1, it means minus 1 plus 7. 3 multiply minus 1, we get minus 3 plus 7. And 7 minus 3 is equal to 4. It means left hand side is equal to right hand side. This question is very simple. Please make a note first. Now we have to solve our next question, question number 7. Look at this question. In this firstly we have to do multiply. But please make a note here. If you get any number here which is not tensor form p by q, but the other side the number is in terms of p by q, then you have to do the process of cross multiplication method. What's the cross multiplication method? It means you have here the terms in terms of numerator and denominator, you make it also x by 1. Now you have to do cross multiply. It means you have to multiply this cross multiplication. So 5 multiply x, we get 5x. Now we have to multiply 1 multiply by 4, we get 4. Now the remaining terms are same. I again repeat, cross multiplication, you have to multiply cross multiplication. So that's why 5 multiply x, we get 5x. 1 multiply by 4, 4, the remaining terms are as it is. Now solve this. Firstly we have to know, we have to solve the bracket, and bracket means multiplications. So you multiply 4 multiply x, we get 4x. 4 multiply by 10, we get 40. We have to separate the variables. So we have to take this 4x on the left hand side, then the sign becomes changed. It becomes negative 4x, which is equal to 40. Now subtract 5x minus 4x, which is equal to x, is equal to 40. This is our values of the x. Now put the values of x in your left hand side. So left hand side is only x, it means we get 40. Now we have to solve the right hand side. What's the right hand side is 4 upon me 5 x plus me 10. Now put the values of x. 4 divided by 5, what's the values of x is 40. 40 plus 10. Firstly you have to solve the bracket. 40 plus 10 is equal to 50, and you know this will be cancelled out on the which table? 5 table. 5 comes up 5, 0 as it is. It means 10 multiply 4, we get 40. So left hand side becomes equal to right hand side. Make a note first. Now we have to do our next question. What it say? The variables have to separate on one side. So it means we have to take this term on the left hand side. So do please, 2x divided by 3, and take this side on the left hand side. 7x by 15, which is equal to 3. We have to take this one on the right hand side. It becomes negative 1. Now what we will get? 7x 15, which is equal to 2. Now you know what's the LCM of 3 and 15? LCM of 3 and 15 is 15. Now solve this. What's the LCM is 15. 3 5s are 15, and we have to multiply 5 into 2, 10x. minus 15 1 50, which we have to multiply 1. 1 into 7x, 7x again 2. You already did such type of question as a LCM question. Now 10x minus 7x, which is equal to 3x by 15, which is equal to 2. Again, these numbers are in rational form, make it as also rational form. Now do cross multiplication. 3x into 1, we get 3x. 15 multiplied to, which is equal to 30. Now solve the values of x. That's why we have to take 3 on the right hand side. It becomes 30 divided by 3. 3 ones are 3, we get 10. It means the values of x is 10. Now you have to do verify. I think you can do by yourself. So please do it yourself. Please make a note first. Now I am going to take our next question, number is 9. 2y plus 5 by 3 is equal to 26 by 3 minus y. The process of the step is same. Firstly, we have to take the variable. Here the variable is y. So in this, we have to take this negative y on the left hand side. It becomes positive y. So we get 2y plus y, which is equal to, sorry, please make a note first. So now we have to take this negative y on the right hand side. Left hand side it becomes positive y, and we have to take this 5 by 3 on the right hand side. So we get 26 divided by 3 plus, here the sign becomes negative because here it is positive. It becomes minus 5 by 3. Now 2y plus y, which is equal to 3y, and we can solve this. This one is LCM is 3, 26 minus 5. 3y is equal to 26 minus 5, which is equal to 21 by 3. If we cut this value, 3 7s are 21, it means we get 7. Then what's the value of y? We have to take 3 on the right hand side. Then it becomes 7 by 3. This is the value of y. Now we have to verify. What's the left hand side is 2y plus 5 by 3. Now solve this. 2 into y. What's the value of y is 7 by 3 plus 5 by 3. 2 into 7, which is equal to 14 by 3 plus 5 by 3. What's the LCM is 3. 14 plus 5, which is equal to 19 by 3. This is our left hand side. Now solve right hand side. What is our right hand side is 26 by 3 minus y. What's the value of y is 7 by 3. Now take 3 as LCM. What we will get? 26 minus 7, which is equal to 19 by 3. It becomes left hand side is equal to right hand side. Quite easy. It's very easy. So make a next question is 3m is equal to 5m minus 8, and the step is same. We have to separate the variable. 3m, we have to take this 5m on the left hand side, and the sign of 5m becomes negative because it is here positive. 3m minus 5m, which is equal to minus 8 upon 5. Now 3m minus 5m, which is equal to minus 2m, which is equal to minus 8 by 5. Again, please make a note. If there is one term on the left hand side and right hand side, and all the terms are negative, so negative are cancelled out on the both side. So this negative will be cancelled out. So we get 2m is equal to 8 by 5. Negative is cancelled out. Negative is cancelled out. Now we have to do cross multiplication, or we have to solve the values of m. What we have to do? We have to take 2 on the right hand side. 8 divided by 5 into 2. You know, 2 fours are 8. It means we get the values of m is 4 divided by 5. 5. Now verify. Left hand side is what? 3m. It means 3 multiply m. What's the value of m is? 4 by 5, which is equal to 3 into 4, 12 by 5. Now what's the right hand side? 5m minus 8 by 5. Now what's the values of m is? 4 by 5 minus 8 by 5. And you know, 5 is a 5. 1 into 4, 4 minus 8 by 5. Now take LCM. We can take divide by 1. What's the LCM is? 5. So 5 fours are 20 minus 8. We get 12 by 5. That's your final result. I hope I make this video as simple as I can do. So do in this technique to solve every type of the question. There are two tests. First you have to separate the variable. Take the variable terms from the one side and the remaining terms from the right hand side. Then you have to solve this. These two approach can do to solve any type of question. I hope you like my video. If you really like my video, so please subscribe my channel and press the button, bell icon button, so that you get automatic notification on your YouTube. My channel is Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. Thank you for watching my video from starting to end. Don't forget to subscribe my channel.